of the emergency intelligence system. This is only a test.
I want to save lives, and I don't want it to be in a lab for the next year and a half as people are dying all over the place.
Doctors are already able to prescribe it.
Well, I'll tell you what I accomplished. We bought massive amounts of it, 29 million doses of it. We have it coming from all of the labs. We're actually now doing it here. Because in case it does work, we want to have it. And we've given it to drugstores. We're sending it all over. FEMA's doing it. FEMA's doing it. We're doing it through different channels, many different channels, including the companies that make it. It's a very special thing. Now, it may not work, in which case, hey, it didn't work. And it may work, in which case, it's going to save a lot of lives. Now, a lot of people say, if the people walking in prior to getting it, if they take it, it has a profound effect. Well, maybe it doesn't, maybe it doesn't. I don't want to wait a year and a half to find out. And only CNN would ask that question. Fake news, go ahead.
Sir, I want to focus first on something that's Dr. Burks, a question. The president just said that, based on the most recent data, that you've seen some change in the projection. I'm wondering if you could, you obviously have a week's more worth of data since the sort of 100,000 to 240,000 potential death figures that you gave us last week. So I'm wondering, with all the caveats, that this is sort of based on continuing social distancing, that we might see, you know, if one city pops, things could change dramatically. What are the sort of range that you're now looking at in terms of total death impact?
I think the most important thing right now is when we were talking about why we are hopeful.